It's sauna weekend here in Canada, so I'm buying my beer in bulk. This is Grandpa's Sweater Oatmeal Stout. Why am I showing you that? From Barnhammer Brewing. I've had this before and I've always liked it. Plus, they're conveniently located right near one of my work locations, so that's awesome too. Let's do a bonus Monday mailbag because it's a long weekend here in Canada. Yay! Okay, let us get started. Says LED module. Seems like a reasonable thing that it could be. Taped together. That's not an LED module, but it is something useful. This is a bunch of turned pin headers. Basically, it's the female header pin, but it's a slightly different and higher quality version. Then, interesting. That's not actually taking a header pin. It's not really designed for it anyway. It's designed more for IC legs and component legs and stuff. Like that. And that is held solidly in there. Let's get the other side in. And that does actually grip them pretty solidly. That's good. Big Clive pointed these out quite some time ago, and I thought they were interesting, so I figured I'd give them a shot. 10 pieces, 40-pin, 2.54mm single row round female pin header socket gold plated. Got these from Xinglongxi. I've bought from them a few times. Currently they're selling for $2.59. I paid $2.46 for them back when I got them, and currently they have shipping on them, which is more than the cost of the item, which is, of course, bullshit. You can search for that search term, and you'll find them, no doubt. I'm going to link to this listing, but as you can see, there's a bunch of others that have them down here, too. And just search with that, and you'll find it. So those turn pin headers contrast against this type of header, which... And they plug into themselves. Yeah. I think these pins are a little bit skinnier than those other ones. Yeah, they can go in there as well. So those are more like an IC pin. And one of the... Well, beyond just gripping tighter, these ones you can also snap off in individuals or whatever count you want. These things, you either have to buy them in a strip of the right size or... take a hacksaw or something and cut them off, and then you'll lose one hole each time you do it. So that's another benefit to them. Next thing in, expansion board module. So many different kinds of expansion board modules. And these actually are modules. Okay. Oh. These are laser diode modules. See that? Laser diode modules. Very similar. Well, it is the same laser diodes that I got in the last mailbag, only these ones are mounted on a little breakout board. Yeah, there's... Oh no, there is something else on there. Hang on, we're going in. It's a resistor. 10 plus 3... 10K resistor? Why is there a 10K resistor on there? What the hell is it doing? There's a pad for another resistor on the bottom, but it's... shorted out. Okay. Strange. And why is there three pins? There doesn't need to be. Oh well. I'm guessing that I bought these at about the same time as I bought the other ones. And I probably ordered them on auction and didn't think I'd get them, so bought the other ones. And yeah, you know.
5 pieces. Laser sensor module. 650 nanometer, 6mm, 5mW, red laser dot diode, copperhead, F Android. No. F and Arduino. Why can't I read today? From World Chips. I paid $2.31 for the 5 of these guys. 5 volt operating voltage output, 650 nanometers with fixed bolt hole. Sure, whatever. Not much else to say. Okay.
Okay, it says 5 volts. I'll give it 5 volts. See what happens. So I'm assuming... the negative is the black wire, and the S is the positive. Yes, it is in fact a laser diode. And it is running at 5 volts, and it's drawing 28 milliamps at 5 volts. Okay. Let's see if I can focus it. Oh yeah, it focuses. Hmm. All of a sudden there's no light and no current. Interesting. Wonder if maybe it isn't a 5 volt device any after all, because these ones said they were 3 volt devices. Hmm. What's next? Another expansion board module. Hmm. Oh, that's tiny. HX2S01. So we got B plus and B minus, battery maybe. P plus and P minus, and BM. I don't think it monitors bowel movements. And then we got BM again and those two guys. And some chips. Maybe the chips will give us a clue as to what this is. That guy calls himself a 20CB. 4406A. And another one of the same. Okay. We should be able to figure this out, even if I can't find the listing.
18650 lithium-ion lithium battery 2S5A charger protection board pad module 7.4 volt, 8.4 volt. So that is, yeah, basically what it is. So put two lithium cells in series and, you know, 4.2 volts max each. So, yeah, that'll do that. But this'll, so I'm guessing the BM is the battery midpoint between the two, between the B plus and the B minus, and then P plus and P minus is, I assume, power coming in. Makes sense. I got this from World Chips. Currently they're selling it for $1.31 Canadian or 99 American pennies. You can find it for about the same price in a bunch of different places. I lucked out and picked this one up, though, for 48 cents at auction, so yay me. What does it say? Built-in three-stage overcurrent detection. Good. Low standby consumption. Controls charge and discharge. Overcharge voltage is 4.25 per cell, 4.25 to 4.35 per cell. Under is 2.5 to 3 volts per cell, which is not bad. 5 amps continuous, that's reasonable. Wide operating temperature, yeah. Stupid low current, that's good. Life cycle, whatever. So much else. So yeah, here we go. So B plus is battery positive, B minus is battery negative, and MB is the midpoint. I guess, right, positive charge and negative charge. Okay. Now, I can maybe run 9-volt things that are tolerant of a little bit less voltage off a pair of lithium-ion batteries. That could be handy. I couldn't find the other chip's data sheet, although I didn't honestly search too hard. But here's the 8-pin chip in a slightly different form factor. It is a 30-volt N-channel MOSFET, and there's two of them, which makes a certain amount of sense in this circuit. And that means the other one is the brains of the operation. But I'm not going to put in too much effort searching for it. It's not really that relevant right now. When I go digging deeper into this thing to play with it, maybe I'll go and spend some more time looking for it.
What have we here? Module. Just module. Okay. Ooh, free rubber band. Yay. Those are always handy. It is, in fact, a module. It has a USB on one side of it, pin headers on the other side, and a chip in the middle. Ooh, it's an FTDI chip. So that would be the FTDI serial to USB breakout board. So that's interesting. I don't actually have an FTDI. My preferred serial to USB is CH340. We've got a couple of different form factors of those. I just figured I'd try something different. This is the one that everybody calls by name, when they're talking about USB to serial, so I think I'd give that a try. Why not?
FT232RL 3.3 or 5.5 volt FTDI USB to TTL serial adapter module for Arduino mini USB port. Got this one from Chengyong 1975. They're currently selling it for $303, but it's on a bit of a discount. It won't be by the time you see this. Anyway, I got it at auction for $2.13. However, I noticed that other people are selling them currently for like a buck and a half or thereabouts. So, caveat emptor. When I bought it, it was the best price I could find at that time.
And the last thing, the big thing, was shipped from within Canada, so there's no lies on the outside of the package. Oh, that looks to me a lot like the standard packaging for RGB or for LED strips, and it says RGB on the outside. Tis in fact RGB LED strip with a lot of connectors. Oh, is this really? Okay. That's unexpected. It is four. These are AKA NeoPixels WS2812s in a bunch of different strips. Okay. That's an interesting way of getting them. The black strip is shorter, or maybe just pulled out further. Okay, how long are those? I'm going to say that's... yeah, it's about a meter. Okay, so that's 4 meters in 1 meter chunks. Okay.
3.2 feet, 144 pixels, WS2812B, individually addressable LED strip light, 50-50 RGB light. From this guy. I bought these four strips at separate auctions, all from the same guy. Currently, he is selling them for $20.46. I got these strips, each individual one, at different auctions between $3.04 and $3.96. Currently, the going rate for them seems to be between in the $8 to $9 range for that same length, so you might be able to find them cheaper on auction occasionally. Not right this moment, apparently, but that's not a bad price for the remote control, but I've already got a bunch of those. Focus, man, focus.
And here is today's mailbag items. Quite an assortment, as usual. Shipping times, the FTDI took 4 weeks. The turnpin headers took 30 days. The charge module took 4 weeks. The laser diodes took 6 weeks. And I seem to have already destroyed one of them. And the RGB strips took 2 weeks to get here. But again, they were shipped from within Canada, so that's not too horrible. Well, I hope you enjoyed today's look in my mail. Happy August long weekend for my fellow Canadians. Thanks to my Patreons for helping to support my silliness. And thanks to the rest of you for watching and for chiming in down in the comments. As usual, I love to hear what you have to say about this. If you got more information than I was able to come up with in my hurried little searching, by all means, feel free to share down below. It helps everybody out, including me. Thanks again.